Figure out what your look is. I don't wear a black suit, white shirt combination all the time to be iconic. No, I wear this because I feel most comfortable in this look and I don't feel a need to experiment. Style lesson number one is still from Tom Ford, have a signature look. Now I love this quote because when I think of Tom Ford, I do think of that black suit with white shirt. For me, it has become iconic. And here's the thing, is he's crafted that image. He has determined what he wants me to see. So my question for you, do you have a signature look? Because here's the thing, if you're not crafting your image, if you're not controlling your image, other people are controlling it for you. And no, this isn't some big conspiracy against you. This is simply the way the human mind works. We categorize people, we put them into boxes. It helps us remember and make sense of the world. So you meet somebody, he looks like a success. You didn't talk to him much, but guess what? You categorized him as a successful person that I want to stay in touch with. This guy could maybe help me get a job in the future. This is someone I want to get to know. Versus the vast majority of people you meet, you kind of move on with. You're like, yeah, it was a nice person, but I'm going to put them in with people that I can safely forget because really there's no consequence. There's no reason that I need to remember this person. And I know that sounds incredibly shallow, but that's the way our mind works because we've got so much information coming at it. The point here is you want a signature look that sends the signals you want to send. Do you want to come off as competent? Do you want to come off as intelligent? Do you want to come off as an authority? Do you want to be perceived as being attractive? Gents, your clothing, your posture, your body language is screaming a message before you even open your mouth. So make sure your signature style is saying what you want it to say. The most important thing is to cleanse and moisturize your face twice a day. Use eye drops. If your eyes are white, you look healthy, you look fresh. Own a magnifying mirror. If you look good magnified, you're good to go. Now, if your knee-jerk reaction to that is, oh, that sounds like way too much, here's the thing. When you're having an important conversation with somebody, where do you spend the majority of your time looking at? Their face, right? So wouldn't it make sense to take care of one of the most important assets you own? Seriously, have you ever had a conversation with someone whose eyes are bloodshot, whose skin looks drained? This person just doesn't look healthy. Now, this may be their normal look, but you're wondering, is this person healthy? Do I want to do business with them? Are they okay? And the importance of your face even more now that we're just doing these video calls. I mean, we don't see anything from the chest down. We just see that face right there on the monitor. Gents, take care of your skin. Take care of your eyes. Have a grooming routine. Now, like a lot of you guys, I've learned a lot from Tom Ford over the years, and I've used a lot of his products. From his eye treatment, to his shaving oil, to his shaving cream, to his body moisturizers, I've used actually a pretty good variety of his products. That being said, I do feel they're a bit overrated. How can I say this? Because I own a men's grooming company called Vitaman, and when I look at our product deck, I think we got better ingredients, and we offer this at a lower price. Our eye treatment, using all natural and organic ingredients, is $25 less expensive. Our shave oil, about one-third the cost of his, and you get more of it. Gents, Vitaman is my company, and I stand behind every product we sell. 100% money back guarantee. So if you're battling wrinkles, if you are dealing with thin hair, and you want a natural solution, we've got you covered. Gents, I'm inviting you to use that link down in the description to go check out Vitaman. This is a company that I'm proud to be a part of. Amazing customer service and natural ingredients in our products that are going to help you look your best. That's the Vitaman promise. Again, gents, use that link down in the description of today's video to get the best deal on the web. A man should try wearing a suit throughout a normal day. I do most things in a suit and sometimes a tuxedo, so I'm very comfortable in them. Now, I love this quote because it takes me back in time. I think of our grandfathers, our great grandfathers. These guys, they did blue collar jobs oftentimes in a suit. Yes, they were working in that suit and it was a suit of armor that they wore that protected them, that made them look great. At the same time, it was functional. Two of the biggest myths out there are one, that suits are uncomfortable, and two, that suits are not functional. So a suit that is uncomfortable is a suit usually that either doesn't fit you well or that you haven't worn enough times to become familiar with it. There's a big difference between uncomfortable and unfamiliar. If you're unfamiliar with something, you're just not used to it. It's like going to the gym for the first time. You just don't know where things are at. You're not used to it. But after you've been to the gym 10 times, you've worn that suit 10 times, it becomes second nature. And let's talk about the functionality of a suit. So yes, if you buy a cheap, inexpensive suit, it will eventually fall apart. But if you buy a quality suit made from wool, this is something that actually is made to be durable, something that you could actually wear again and again, made from a dark color. It can even take some stains. And if you wore it as your daily go-to suit, you'd be surprised at how rough you can be with this thing and how well it's going to serve you. Now, a lot of people think a high armhole is restrictive, but it's actually not because it gives you full movement because it's cut all the way up to the arm. I love this quote because it goes back to that last point that suits can be incredibly comfortable and functional. You can have a lot of freedom of movement if it fits you properly. And I've talked about this before on the style pyramid. Fit, function, and fabric. Pay attention to that fit. It's at the top of the pyramid for a reason. Fit is king. At home, off duty, I wear t-shirts from Fruit of the Loom, but I have them tailored. If the sleeves are cut over the tricep, they look so much better. Now, this quote is for those of you guys that want to keep it casual. You're saying, you know what? I'm a t-shirt and jeans type of guy. If that is you, well, at least make sure when you buy your t-shirts and your jeans, you buy clothing that fits you perfectly right out the package, or you take the time to get it adjusted. And gents, you can do a lot of these adjustments yourself. They're very simple, or maybe even go to a tailor. Point being is small adjustments can make a huge difference in the way it looks and the way it fits. A good trick as you get older is to get a thick pair of glasses that have a dark frame. Everything else can droop and slide, but that pair of dark glasses stays sharp and crisp. What do you think? Like my gentleman glasses? I don't know about the style, but I do agree with Tom Ford's point about find glasses that work for your face. They can balance out the face and they can provide symmetry, especially if one side of your face starts to droop more than the other. If you're an older guy and you want to bring in a bit of creativity, color, you can do that with glasses. One of the most underutilized accessories a man can own. Always keep your jacket buttoned. If I had one rule for men, it's this. It instantly makes your silhouette. I agree. When you stand, button your jacket. If it's a two-button jacket, button the top, never button the bottom. If it's a three-button jacket, the top button, optional. The center button, required. The bottom button, never. On the other hand, when seated and to give yourself a little bit more room, unbutton that jacket. Even with a soft jaw, when you trim your beard well, you'll look sharp and chiseled. Completely agree. And you can even leverage the power of stubble. So if you're not going to go full beard, then just don't shave for a few days and see what it looks like. But if you decide to go with a beard, congratulations. Nothing can shape a man's chin better than a beard. What works with your skin and eyes? Use that to zero in on with your wardrobe. Now it sounds simple, the proper use of color, but so many guys mess this up. A couple pieces of simple advice here. First, don't shy away from your favorite colors. As a kid, olive green, dark greens were some of my favorite colors. Why? Because every time I wore these, I got complimented. I was just drawn to these colors. And lo and behold, they are some of the best colors for me and my skin tone. Seriously, most guys are already drawn to their favorite colors. They just need to have the courage to bring them into their wardrobe. And if it's a bright color like yellow, orange, red, obviously don't wear a full suit in that color, but you can use it in accent pieces. And speaking of accent pieces, the next piece of advice, look to your eyes. So if you've got piercing blue eyes, great green eyes, again, this is going to be a great way to bring in accent colors to your wardrobe. Me, I've got dark brown eyes. So again, brown is one of the colors that I gravitate towards, especially in trousers and even in jackets. British men are peacocks. You see a lot more style on the streets here than you see anywhere else on every level. Now, this one's a big generality, but I have to overall agree. In my experience in London, I saw a lot of well-dressed men traveling over to Italy, the same thing. I think that there are parts of the world where men spend a lot more time on their presentation, and to them, they understand the power and why it matters. So if you want to dress well, and in your area, nobody does, what you want to do is take online inspiration. So yes, tons of options out there. Find a great Instagram to follow. Go out there and find somebody who's got similar colors, similar complexion, maybe a movie star, somebody over in Bollywood. Find somebody that you really like their look and their styles and copy, imitate. No one's going to say you're dressing like Ryan Gosling. You're dressing like SRK. No one's going to say that. What they're going to say is, wow, you're looking good. You've got style and you know the secret. You're kind of imitating somebody else's look. If you're at the Oscars, there's not a man on that red carpet who is not wearing makeup. Most straight actors I know get quite used to it. Even when they go out in real life, they grab some sort of bronzer and they throw it on. Now, I know a lot of you guys are saying, I would never do that. But here's the thing. When you turn 25 and you start losing your hair, or you're 23 in law school and you've got the most important presentation of your life today, and you wake up and there is a huge pimple right here on the end of your nose. The point is, I want you to be confident. Whatever product you use, never feel ashamed for taking the steps to feel more confident so that you can go out there and you can fulfill your dreams. I didn't grow up in a wealthy family. We were a middle-class American family, but we knew the rules. We knew that an afternoon wedding was a daytime suit, that black shoes were worn with blue suits and brown shoes with gray. Now, this quote's interesting because he lays out some rules and he talks about the importance of knowing the rules. But what he doesn't talk about, and this is where I would expand on his quote, is that if you know the rules and you understand why they're there, have the courage to bend, to break the rules. Now, I'm not saying that if there's a dress code, to break that dress code, because that's about the person that's throwing the party and the ambiance they're trying to create. But I am saying, you know what? If you really want to wear brown shoes with a blue suit and you think the look is amazing, then go ahead and break that rule. The purpose of style rules is to give you guidance when you're just starting off so you don't make any critical errors. But style rules shouldn't be style laws. They shouldn't be there to constrict. If you understand the basis of why the rule is there, but it doesn't apply to you, then of course, break the rule. Never, ever, ever wear anything you are uncomfortable in. Gents, your clothing, your wardrobe is a tool. It should enhance your image. To do that, you've got to have the right tools and then you need to practice using them. My advice here, gents, build a simple, interchangeable wardrobe and love everything that you own. Want to learn how to build that interchangeable wardrobe? Check it out here, guys. 256 outfits from 16 pieces of clothing. Find out how in this video right here.